A legend says goodbye to Pittsburgh after dominating the Pitt Panthers. Coach K coaches his last game as head coach of Duke in Pittsburgh with a victory as he picks up a win over Pitt, a 30-point beatdown win, 86-56. This is your Pitt Postgame show. We're going to talk some Coach K, of course, and we're also going to talk this game, I guess. As I'm your host, Mike Asti here on Pittsburgh Sports Live and Pittsburgh Sports Now. I am joined by our Pitt basketball beat writer, George Michalowski of Pittsburgh Sports Now. And yeah, honestly, Duke won it from the jump. Those tickets were on sale. People were paying a little bit more to get there for the moment. And maybe you're paying to watch Coach K and Duke, because if you're a Pitt fan, it was certainly a rough day at the Pete. But to be expected, honestly, with how Pitt has been playing, despite being more competitive weeks ago, they certainly haven't been recently, and Duke continuing to ride high and trying to propel themselves and get wins like this as we are now in March. So an important season for Duke, maybe not so much for Pitt or the region, really. George, to get things started here, just what was the atmosphere like? This is obviously a big deal in the sense that Coach K is a legend. This is a Bob Knight, John Wooden. This is a legendary figure who is closing his chapter. This is decades upon decades upon decades. He has been coaching at Duke and bringing this program to extreme elite level of success longer than we've been alive. And Pitt's been a foe of Duke over the years. Certainly Duke has been a program that Pitt fans look up at and feel like they maybe never could get over that Mount Everest, certainly since coming to the ACC, but they've had their battles over the years. Obviously the connection between Coach K and Jeff Capel is a strong one, with Jeff Capel growing up as a coach under Coach K and that mentorship relationship going on. This game was never up in the air, and I think everyone probably knew going in it was going to end this way. But what was the atmosphere like? What did Coach K have to say? What did Jeff Capel have to say in terms of about this moment for Coach K overall, outside of the game itself?
Yeah, it was a great atmosphere. I mean, for all things considered for Pitt, you know, this was their most crowded game of the year. And, you know, besides the West Virginia game at West Virginia, obviously, but
the feeling
of this game was the complete opposite. You know, it didn't feel like a rivalry. It didn't feel chippy. You know, none of the Pitt fans were chanting at Coach K anything negative or anything like that. You know, he got a standing ovation when he walked in. You know, he didn't come out for warmups at all. All the other coaches did, all the other teams did. You know, he came out 10 minutes to go right before tip off. You know, Coach K walks out of the tunnel, the whole place stands up. A lot of Duke fans in attendance. So yeah, it was an interesting atmosphere. There were a lot of people here, not a lot of hatred in the crowd, you know, kind of a lot of people just, it seemed like a lot of people just admiring all of the talent that Duke had. And on top of that, the winningest coach of all time, you know, in the same. So it was all eyes on Duke. I mean, a 30-point win, you know, it was funny because Pitt didn't play, you know, all that bad as we've seen them play this year. We've seen Pitt struggle, you know, turning the ball over a ton, not shooting well at all. But, you know, they got some good looks tonight. You know, Pitt had some good performances. John Hughley played really well. But Duke was just that much more talented. You know, they had three guys, Trevor Keels, Paolo Banchero, and A.J. Griffin, freshmen, who just dominated this game from start to finish. And it was more oohs and ahs from the crowd than boos. So, yeah, it was an interesting atmosphere. There was a ceremony for Coach K before the game. Jeff Capel and Pitt presented him with a steel fist. And that fist, you know, Coach K and Capel just talked about it in the post-game press conference. It's been a staple of the Duke program for years, since Capel was recruited to go there. So, you know, it's got five fingers, obviously: communication, trust, collective responsibility, care, and pride. So that's what Krzyzewski's basing his program off of, you know, for 40 plus years, and he's become the winningest coach of all time behind those principles. And Capel and Pitt gifted him a steel fist. So that was the significance of the ceremony. Pitt had a nice video tribute The atmosphere was something we haven't really seen this year at all out of a Pitt game. But it was definitely a good sign, you know, for the program to have that many people in the building.
Yeah, Pitt does lose by 30 to Duke. Coach K's last game in Pittsburgh. You have the moment before the game. You kind of have the fans acting respectable, even to a rival during the game. You have a weird atmosphere, kind of, and you have a packed house, which Pitt hasn't really had most of this season, or really at all this season, with how miserable it has been at times. It's now a 3-game losing streak for Pitt after winning a few in a row. Pitt now 11-19 on the season. Duke, I believe, 26-4 now, number 4 in the country. That might even increase if they keep dominating teams. They had that loss to Virginia way back, but it's been a win streak ever since then. So, yeah, you have the relationship between Coach K and Jeff Capel, and it's a memorable atmosphere, I'm sure, for even you, and it's a cool atmosphere for Pitt fans to have experienced. I'm sure it maybe will be duplicated whenever Jim Boeheim announces that he is done and he has his last moment in Pittsburgh. I'd imagine a similar atmosphere may occur. Hey, a similar atmosphere may occur for Bob Huggins when he makes that announcement, especially if you do it ahead of time. So when you have a legend, we saw this with Derek Jeter in baseball, when you make the announcement ahead of time, it does allow for gifts, closed fists, and all this ceremonies and celebrations and things like this. When you know it ahead of time, you can prepare, and of course, video tribute. So Pitt fans are ready. The Pitt program was ready. It was a classy way to send him off. And honestly, just my thoughts on Duke and Coach K, the fact that it's one thing to be a Hall of Fame legendary figure, and certainly if you have the most wins and national titles and Final Fours, et cetera, and look at the resume that Coach Faith put together. But people forget, and, you know, we weren't around for it, but you got to look back into history. The Duke program, it was okay. It was good, but it wasn't this. Coach K built that program to what it became with him, with that closed fist philosophy. It took years to get that. It took different eras of dynasties to get where it is. And now it might be easy to recruit at Duke. If you have the grades and you're a talent, you're going to want to go there. But it wasn't that way when he first got the job. So he had to build it to what it became. So that's definitely an extra feather in the cap to do it at a program that wasn't that way before he got there. It's kind of like Bobby Bowden in football at Florida State. Wasn't the case before he built it up to being that. Whereas, okay, if you dominate at a school that has a pedigree, that's one thing, but doing it when you're building it up, that's another. George Michalowski joining me here, Pittsburgh Sports Now, Pittsburgh Sports Live. We are talking Coach K's last game as Duke head coach in Pittsburgh, a 30-point shellacking of the Pitt Panthers, who now lose 3 in a row and are 11-19 on the year. But as George did also touch on there, this is a game against the number 4 team in the country that wants to beat down teams because they're looking for a deep run into March. And this is a Pitt team that also has been struggling recently. But if you look at this game realistically and with a keen eye, yeah, there were some maybe bright spots for Pitt in a game that they had no chance of competing in anyway. Even if you see the final score, Ugly ends up dominating in terms of his offensive output, and you get a few others to step up as well. So what are your thoughts on the game itself in particular from the Pitt perspective? What can Jeff Capel sell to his team that, yeah, Coach K's last game, they're way better than you. They kicked you, you know what, but it's not the end of the world because this is Duke and there are some bright spots. Can you paint it with some bright spots, or there's positive to take out of this if you're a Pitt fan at all?
Yeah, I mean, you mentioned Hughley's performance, and that's got to be the number one thing that comes to mind, you know, for Capel, for people trying to convince other people around the program that this thing's moving in the right direction. You know, 19 points, he made over 50% of his shots. You know, Capel said after the game, he said, you know, they told John at halftime, you know, they're not doubling you. Duke isn't double teaming you like everyone else has.
Right.
So go right at him. And he did just that. You know, he made the change, he adapted, and he went right inside and attacked like we've seen all year from him.
Burton, so 13, even 6-for-9.
Right, and Burton from the very start, you know, I thought he was going to end up being the leading scorer just because in the first half, you know, he was definitely attacking more than Hughley. He showed a good mid-range game. I mean, he's loved the mid-range shot all year. It hasn't always gone in. You know, there's been games where he goes three right. for 11, four for 12, and you're kind of scratching your head. But, you know, tonight, 6 for 9 from the field, you know, he made his four of his first five shots today. So 13 points for Burton, kind of slowed down in the second half. But again, both of those were solid performances, you know, but the reason there weren't more of those, you know, the reason that Pitt's not going to hang their head is, like you said, Duke's talent on both sides of the ball is just absurd. Like, they're ranked yeah. number four right now in the country. They just won the Big East or the ACC regular. Or I think they have a chance to win it outright against North Carolina. Yeah.
And Gonzaga just lost. So, like, this can be shaken up. Yeah.
So, ACC regular season champs, you know, number four team in the country. They're most likely, if they do well in the ACC tournament and beat North Carolina, they're going to be a one seed, if not a two. I mean, they're right there. They're one of the best teams in the country. So, you know, they were all over Pitt. You know, these guys are – each player almost is more athletic and almost stronger than Pitt's guy at that position. So, you know, all things considered, you know, Pitt came out and they came out slowly. You know, their defense struggled outside right away, but they kind of, for the most part, I guess you could say hung around, because it's tough to say that because they lost by 30, obviously.
But, right.
You know, there's still some moments where Pitt didn't look all that bad. You know, I just think it could have been much worse for this team. You know, Pitt that struggled so much this year, and Duke that's won 7 straight, you know, is pretty much the most talented team in the country on paper. And then now is looking like the most complete team in the country. So Duke's going to be a tough team to beat in March. That's for sure.
Yeah. And Coach K has this team playing the best when you want them to be at their best. And of course, Coach K has had flame outs in early rounds of NCAA tournaments in addition to the Final Fours and national title. It's not guaranteed that he's going to have a deep run, but this is a Duke team that has 4 losses. If Pitt maybe would have had this game months ago, maybe Pitt would have had more of a chance in this. Duke had struggled at one point this year, but it seems like just a distant memory, and it seems like a totally different Duke team that was struggling earlier in the year than the team that you watched here in this game. Now, again, you look at this game and there's a 30-point difference here despite some positive outputs here for Pitt. Was there anything else said by Capel in terms of this game outside of just a relationship with Coach K about, you know, his thought process to this game and what his thought process is the rest of the year here for Pitt, as you still have that Notre Dame game coming up? And that was a Notre Dame team that Pitt actually thought they let get away earlier this year, losing by 1 point and kind of collapsing down the stretch.
Right. So he didn't really get into much after the game about, you know, the rest of the season. It was kind of more of an explanation of what he does after each game. So he said, Cable said after the game, he said, you know, I didn't give a long speech to my team after this game. You know, we lost by 30 points, but I wasn't down there yelling at them. I wasn't down there picking apart everything. And he said, his philosophy, and ever since he's been a young coach, he's done this, is take a day or two, you know, to digest the game, you know, watch it over again, then deal with it without as much emotion, you know. So obviously the emotion coming from frustration from the actual game. And then tonight, right, you know, he talked all about how he was very emotional before the game with the pregame ceremony for his coach. So he kind of just focused on that and how he is hoping that his team will respond, but that they still need time to look into exactly what they did and then get ready for Notre Dame and obviously try to make some sort of a run at the ACC tournament. So, yeah, you know, I mean, they're going to try against Notre Dame. They got close earlier in the year, 1 point loss to Pete, but that was also a completely different Notre Dame team. So the Irish are hot, you know, coming down the stretch, you know, just like Coach K, Mike Bray's got him rolling. So it's going to be a tough end of the year for Pitt, it's looking like, but there's obviously a chance.
Yeah, and one other thing too, you look at Mo Guy with the 6 points in this game after being in double digits in points the last several games, even during Pitt's recent losing streak, and certainly with the struggling season they've had, one, I guess, positive part of the team. People brought this up earlier in the year that maybe they could use this to be competitive, is what Pitt could bring defensively, despite the offensive depth not being there and being such a one-man driven team. And it had been there at times. It had not been there at times. They did allow 90 plus points to Wake Forest. So certainly they've had their bad moments defensively as well this year, but 86 here to Duke. Duke, obviously one of the best teams in the country, and only the six from Mo Guy. Was it just that Duke is just so freaking good that it's hard to evaluate this game in comparison to the recent games, or did he have an off night, anything different from his night in comparison to the recent games, 11 and then 20 plus, and even this team defensively, did they bring a worse defensive effort in this game in comparison to others? Or again, is this just Duke? Because that's also possibly an answer.
Right, so it was definitely part of both. And Jeff Capel also said that after the game in his post-game press conference. You know, he said, obviously, in the first half, you know, we all saw it, Pitt was struggling to switch on the outside. And the way that Duke moves the ball is as fast as anyone, as crisp as anyone, as perfect as anyone that Pitt's seen this year. So Duke was, you know, they weren't even setting a ton of screens. It's just the rotations that Pitt was sending around the outside were way too slow. It took him a long time to adapt to, you know, how Duke moved the ball, how Duke screened the outside. So, number one, yes, Pitt did struggle defensively in the beginning. They got out – I mean, Duke made four of their first five threes, got out to a 16-3 lead to start it out. I think it was 23-7 right after that. Yeah. So, you know, certainly a slow start, but also, I mean, you have to give credit also for Gee's performance not being great. You have to give credit to – just how good Duke is, like we've been talking about. So Cable talked about how Duke goes small and they have Bancaro at the five, who's 6'10", 250, and can play one through five. So they're going small, but it's still a nightmare matchups for pretty much everyone on Pitt. You know, obviously John Hughley's a powerful guy. He can go into Paolo down low like that, but the length that they have, you know, the speed that they have in transition, the athleticism that each of those guys have, you know, the power that a guy like Trevor Keels, their point, they're one of their guards, you know, 27 points, he makes five threes, but he's also like one of the strongest guards in the ACC. So these guys are just built different for Duke, and they showed it tonight. It was certainly a combination of a lot of things that went into the 30-point win.
Yeah, clearly there's a talent disparity between Duke and Pitt. And it's not even insulting to Pitt. That's just the case. Jeff Capel knows it. They know it. That's just the situation here. And speaking on Pitt defensively as well, also allowing the 85 to Miami in a loss. So that's a lesser team than Duke that you also allow 80 plus. And prior to allowing 85 to Miami and now 86 to Duke, Pitt had not allowed 80 plus since the Wake Forest game. And if you take out that Wake Forest game, you're looking at months and months and months since they allowed 80 plus, mostly 70 and 60s, even into the 50s in some of these games. So again, Pitt's offense not good enough. The struggling Pitt team that dealt with a lot on and off the court. It's been a bad year for the Pitt Panthers. But defensively, they've been okay most of this year, except for some of these recent games. And then, of course, some of those games earlier in the year and then that one smack dab in the middle. So Pitt does lose this one by 30 points to Coach K. Coach K ends up getting a gift from Pitt with the closed fist and a nice little victory. So Pitt gives him a win as he ends his Pitt time and his coaching career at Duke in Pittsburgh. George, I appreciate the time. The Pitt Panthers do have that matchup against Notre Dame on the road on Saturday at 2:30 p.m. tip-off. That's one Jeff Capel said that he literally felt like that was one that got away. That was almost the only press conference of the year that he really did come off that, hey, we should have won this game. We'll see what happens here in this output. What are you looking for in that game, separate from a win or a loss, because obviously Pitt's still likely to lose. But what are you looking for as we close up this show here and maybe our last postgame show of the regular season here? What are you looking for in terms of either an effort, in terms of individual play, in terms of maybe keeping this score a little bit closer than recent games because that's a team that's good, but they're not Duke?
Right.
Where are your eyes for that regular season finale against Notre Dame?
Well, I think as anyone who has been around the program for the past few years in the Jeff Capel era would say, you got to focus on the effort, number one, because it sounds dumb at first to, you know, hear someone say, you know, oh, let's watch Pitt's effort this game. Like, you know, who cares? Like, they're always going to try, obviously. But obviously the past few years, guys have left. You know, guys have visibly given up on each other, on their team chemistry, on playing together, and they've actually transferred out. And with the transfer portal being so prevalent nowadays, you know, it's very much so possible again. So, I mean, I'm going to look. I think everyone's looking for John Hughley, you know, his effort down low, obviously because he's the star. I don't think we already talked about this on our last show. You know, I haven't seen any signs of him, you know, slowing down. You know, I think he's actually handled the long season great for being pretty much a freshman this year. I think he's given pretty much all he's got out there. So, you know, he's been great. I think you also have to look at, you know, some of the other younger guys. You know, Femi Odekala, he struggled a lot of times this year scoring. Who knows if that's in his mind bugging him, you know, I need more touches sort of thing. So you got to look at, you know, obviously the matchup with Notre Dame, who is, like you said, not Duke. You know, they're a beatable top of the line ACC team. Other than the matchup with them and how Pitt fares there, I think you got to look at some of the individual, you know, performances, especially some of the young guys. You know, tonight, Will Jeffers, you know, it kind of looked in the past few games that he was gaining step by step, gaining a little more confidence. But, you know, bright lights tonight, obviously he struggled a lot. So it's going to be tough. But I think the focus has to be on, if anything, Pitt's young guys, Pitt's young core. And yeah, you know, Mogi's gone after this year. Tamarius Burton has the chance, you know, to come back. So, you know, Dan Oladapo has a chance to go back. So we'll see. You know, you got to just look at who's going to be on the roster next year and how they show their effort in this game against Notre Dame in the ACC tournament and all that. So,
yeah. And then Pitt fans will wait and see an off season of who's going to be on this team next year. Mikey Zibondi, a player that was not a part of this team this year, was emerging now two seasons ago, figuring this season basically is over. So we'll see to the future of the Pitt Panthers. Obviously on this night, it was never going to be Pitt's night. Coach K is it for this night, not the Pitt Panthers. A 30-point victory for Coach K, his last game in Pittsburgh as head coach of Duke, as he closes the chapter in his illustrious legendary career with March in front of him to see what Duke will do in the ACC tournament and then the NCAA tournament. The madness of March will close the end of Pitt season here pretty soon, and we will see if they can make any noise and end well and show effort or do anything in a tournament to kind of impress, whether it be media fans or whoever else, going into the offseason and trying to build from there. George, I appreciate the time as always. I'm sure I'll be talking to you again here at some point here before we officially close things up on Pitt season, and then we'll do something here on the air, and you can give a letter grade to Pitt season, which that'll be interesting. Because I mean, I'm going to assume is, you know, they're not passing with flying colors, but are they completely failing? I guess will be the question. Yeah. But have a good night, man.